Okay, Michael, have you thought about it? Do you know what the answer is?
Yeah, I think. You know, you asked it in a funny way, but I think what you're asking maybe was pretty simple. So let me see if I can talk it through. So we've got n data points. Each learner is a zeroth order polynomial. So you said the ensemble rule is that you learn over a subset. A zeroth order polynomial is just that. Well, we said that the thing that minimizes the average, sorry, that minimizes the expected error or the squared error in a zeroth order polynomial, it's just the average. So if the sets are n distinct sets with one data point each, then each of the individual learners is just going to learn the average. Then they get, not the average, sorry, the actual output value of each individual point is the average. And then the combining algorithm, to combine all the pieces of the ensemble into one answer, combines with the mean. So it's going to combine the mean of those, each of which is the data point. So it's the mean of the data points. So the ensemble outputs, I don't know, I'd say average or mean
Yes.
or zeroth order polynomial of the data set or, one node decision tree or.
A constant, which happens to be the mean of the data. Haven't we seen this before?
It seems to come up a lot when we are outputting very simple hypotheses.
Right. And the last time we did this, if I recall correctly, this is what happens if you do an unweighted average with k and n, where k is equal to n.
Oh, right. Like right. N.
N. So we should probably do something a little smarter than this then. And I thought that we might look at some of the housing data because no one's tired of looking at the housing data yet. Okay. So let's look at that right quick and see if we can figure out how this works and then see if we can do something a little bit better, even better than that. Okay?